Welcome to Tigers TV for today's game between Telford Tigers and the Sheffield Steeldogs. This is Sheffield's second trip to Telford this season and Tigers will be looking to get the win this time round. The Steeldogs went away with the points last time out. Before the game we went and caught up with Tigers assistant coach Carl Creamer. Carl, so tough game last night and a disappointing performance and a kind of tough result. Looking to bounce back against the Steeldogs today.
Don't know dwell on last night at all. In light of all the great news for the Tigers, new ownership and everything else going forward, these guys aren't jumping hoops through hoops at the moment and doing whatever it takes to be part of this team going forward, then they're sadly going to miss out on something big time. I didn't see anything like that last night. I didn't see anybody jumping, coming forward saying, I want to be part of this. At times it was pretty pathetic as well. But hey, some good stuff. Declan played great and then Sam went in cold when we wanted to give Deck a bit of a rest and he did fantastic. 1-1 third period. So most of it was good, but some of it was really bad.
And moving on, like you say, it's been a fantastic week for Tigers this week with the news of the new ownership and lots of resources coming in to really drive us forward. And you know, nothing's been seen so far in terms of changes for the team, but looking on to today's game, a chance to get back on track and get the 2 points against a tough physical team.
And these guys got beat last night at home, they're going to come out strong. But hey, we need a bounce back game, they need a bounce back game. Ours just needs to be better than theirs. Home ice, we've got to win.
Thank you. We'll be back in 13 minutes with the team in second period one point left. In the meantime, Owen Bennett is going to make the draw for the September 100 Club winner. Thank you. We have a reminder that flash photography is not permitted in the building. That's flash photography is not permitted in the building. Thank you.
So Tom, disappointing result tonight and again a loss away yesterday. What are your thoughts on the weekend in Hull?
Obviously disappointed to come away with nothing. We had great news on Friday evening that the club have got new ownership, which makes us financially very strong. And for us to go out and play the way we did on Saturday, I felt the group as a whole lacked a lot of attitude and a lot of commitment. But I kind of think we kind of had that attitude and commitment tonight. So, you know, we're a young group right now. We need to find some experience to come into the roster and help out. Obviously, it doesn't help having Scott McKenzie out of the lineup and then losing an important Mika this evening. But in terms of the performance yesterday, A, it wasn't good enough. B, I felt it was soft, which was not very good at all. So to come home tonight, we try to get a message into the players that you've got to come and compete. And I think certainly we competed. I think we lacked that little bit of cutting edge to really make a difference to the scoreline. Our power play was sluggish, and really our offence, it kind of felt like we weren't really going to get much. I thought their goaltender's good, and we didn't get much in key scoring areas, you know, in front of the net, in top of the slot, whereas the flip side of that, Sheffield seemed to have an abundance of chances. So our goaltending's been strong all weekend, but it's up to the guys in there to make sure that penny's dropped. And you know, if they want to be part of something that's going to be really, really big, it's up to them to prove to us that they've got the ability to play here.
And just talking about Mika's injury, obviously he's gone off to hospital. Have we got any more news on how he is?
Well, I haven't got any news really from after the game. Nothing's come back. I believe he might have gone into surgery. You know, it's never nice to see somebody injured, but it's never nice to see somebody injured in the way that happened. It's a blatant slash to the finger. It severed his finger, and we don't know what's going to happen to Mika. So right now we're pretty angry, pretty disappointed. It's the second week running that we've lost a guy to injury to you know, what's really a cheap play and really uncalled for. You know, we go down last weekend, we lose Scott McKenzie, we don't know how long Scott will be out, the guy that makes the hit, whether it's malicious or not. You know, he's back in the game, one game suspension, doesn't really seem fair. And same thing this evening, whether it's a malicious play or not, you know, the guy's seriously injured. We lose a guy possibly for potentially the rest of the season. You know, and what happens then? Does a guy come straight back and play after one or two games? And to me, that doesn't feel right. I think the league have got to set a precedent in a lot of these incidents that are happening around the league and really clamp down on some of the stuff that are causing serious injury.
and just talking about Mika as a player for a second, he's really come on well over the kind of short time he's been here and been a big asset for the team.
He has. I mean, you know, when we did our recruitment through the summer, we've still been working and still are working from a limited budget at the minute. So to find a guy with Mika who's come in, and he's come from a league that really we didn't know a heck of a lot about. His work ethic's fantastic. His skating's very good. You know, we've had chats with Mika, and ideally we want our imports to produce more, but I think from the work ethic and what he does on as a two-way player, you know, in offence and defence, has been very, very good. He's a quiet guy, but every game he goes out and gives a consistent performance, and he has been a thorn in some other teams' sides, and there has been some cheap shots on the kid, which, you know what, I don't think that's necessary. He's here. He's not a mean guy. He's not a nasty guy at all. And he goes out and he plays the same way every night. So for us to be without that work ethic, it's a huge loss.
And then just moving on to next weekend, we play Guildford here on the Saturday night before we go up to Manchester and take them on. So two of the very top teams who are both playing really well at the moment.
Yeah, you know, this league's a tough league. Sheffield's got a good team, and I said in my programme notes previously that they've got a lot of good British players that would step into many rosters. You know, and then you come back off the back of that with Guildford and Manchester, two of the top teams, two teams that have won the league in the playoff last season. So, you know, we've got to be ready to play. And I think the mental side of it is huge. If we can get our legs going, if we can get our bodies into it physically, and our skating ability is great, we're perhaps not as good on the puck as some other teams, but if we can play the game with a lot of heart, a lot of grit, you know what, then we can knock these guys over. And we know Manchester a little bit. They made us look a little bit silly here, so we went up there last year and we put in a couple of great performances, and we're looking for us to do the same. It's not going to be an easy weekend at all, but we've got a group of guys that are a good group of guys, but they need to learn fast and they need to pick up the slack, really.
And then finally, just touching on the announcement on Friday, you know, new ownership for the club, and obviously kind of Wayne Scholes, who's the CEO of that company and set the new ownership up. Obviously, you know, kind of a very successful businessman with lots of ideas and stuff and resources to put into the club. From a coach's perspective, you know, what are your kind of hopes for the future?
Obviously, right now the main thing for us is that we've got the stability, we've got the security as a hockey club to move forward. You know, we've been living hand to mouth for the last three, 4 years, and there's been a lot of edgy, nervy moments. That is hopefully gone, which I'm pretty certain of. Speaking to Wayne and speaking to Wayne's staff, the plans that they've got for the club are huge. And from my point of view as a hockey coach, it's excellent. You know, you want to be able to go and compete, and you want to be able to go and win. And you know, we're not developing a team anymore. Hopefully we're putting a team together that is a team full of experienced pros. But I think the thing being for our young guys, if that happens, then they should be learning off these players and not seeing it as a negative. It would be a great opportunity for everybody in the dressing room. But we've got to prove it, myself included. You know, I've got responsibility to make sure that once we get this started and once we get the players in that perhaps we like, you know what, I've got to prove to my boss that we've got to win hockey games. And I think we're more than capable of doing that.
Tigers round off a tough weekend here with a 3-1 loss to the Sheffield Steeldogs. But join us again next week on Tigers TV when they take on the Guildford Flames.